This is the TRX4 Sport kit. And if you're like me, you want to get the best performance off-road on the rocks with this thing, you've got to face the same dilemma I'm facing, which is, do I cut the pretty body and save a bit of weight to get that extra bit of performance, or do I leave it like that so I can enjoy it? Because it is gorgeous. Today, we're going to do a little test. We're going to get this thing on the rocks. We're going to do a few laps with the stock body as it is. Then we're going to take my heavier comp truck body and throw it around the course as well. And then I'm going to do a naked course. Don't worry, I'll be wearing clothes. It's just going to be the truck chassis without the body. And then we're going to do a tip test and see just how much difference weight up top makes. Stick around. I've weighed the body already. It's nearly 500 grams. I've got my beat up old 80 series Land Cruiser comp body. It's definitely seen better days. This thing has a full light kit and an interior for the scale points. And it's been to numerous competitions interstate. This thing weighs just over a kilogram. So we've got half a kilogram and we've got 1 kilogram. I'll do 3 rounds with each. I've got a nice big battery in the front today. And what we're going to do is take the best score from each of the 3 runs. And then that's going to give us some idea of just what weight is worth to a crawler. I've intentionally kept it unmodified. We're going to do an upgrade series, but for now, all it has is these heavier wheels. And they add about 120 gram, or 110 grams per corner over the stock wheels. I started the course with the Lexan body, which is nearly half a kilogram. The worst score was the first lap you saw there with a score of -9. This lap here, the second lap, was the best score with -20, -30 being the best possible score. And the third was -12. The average for this body was -13.6. Now this is the control test with no body. All 3 scores here were pretty close. The first was -15. The second, which is this one, was -11, and the third was -16. So that's an average of -14 compared to -13.6 on the Lexan. So that's close as makes no difference, honestly. Now the hard body I had to adapt from my other TRX4, it didn't quite fit with the sport, but anyway. First was the worst, -3. Second lap, this one here, was -11, and the third was -15, which was the best. So that's 3 very similar scores, -20, -16, and -15. That's Lexan, no body, and styrene.
Okay, I've just had this thing around the course 3 times. We had it with the stock body, then naked, and then with this hard body. Now I had to do a bit of a tape job. I do actually have a mounting point for my other TRX4, but the sliders don't quite line up, so my holes didn't line up, so I just had to tape it, but the effect is the same. So now I'd like to see how the hard body affects the tip test. Yeah, 39.5 it goes on. I'll uninstall my high-tech retention system. Oink. Now that was a 1 kilogram, remember? That was a sticker from the Australian Nationals. So this is 1 kilogram. Now with the Sport Naked, we still have the battery in it. Logically, it'll do better. So that's 39.5 now. That's the angle that it went on with the hard body. And so we get to 45. And it's actually balancing now, it's on that point. So we'll call that 45. Now remember, the body is just under half a kilogram, with the idea being that more weight up top is worse for tip point, of course, center of gravity. Now remember, it went 39.5 it went with the hard body, and 45 it went with no body. It's lifting at 41.5. So changing nothing else, the idea is that the less weight you have up top, and you knew this already, but how much of a difference did it make? Well, now you know. Now, the lap results weren't all that different, which I find kind of interesting. The tip test is more scientific than the driving test because it's really hard to iron out any inconsistencies. There's my driving, there's the line I pick, and all the rest of it, which is why I did 3 laps of each. But just as an indication, at least, less weight for side hilling is definitely advantageous. And as far as driving goes, the scores were kind of similar. It was certainly quicker with less weight up top. And certainly the hard body made it pretty tough to drive, but the stock body and the naked body weren't all that different. I'd be inclined, honestly, just to keep this because, I mean, look, the back of it's just so pretty. Anyway, thank you for joining me for this little exploration of body weight. Throw me a like if you found this useful, and I'll catch you next time on RC-TNT.